संसार सिंधु उत्तरणे हृदयं यदि साद संकीर्तनमृतरसे रमते मनोश्चे प्रेमाम्बुधौ विहरणे यदि चित्तवीति चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम संसार सिंधु उत्तरणे हृदयं यदि साद संकीर्तनमृतरसे रमते मनोश्चे प्रेमाम्बुधौ विहरणे यदि चित्तवीति चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड वी आर गोइंग टू डाई वेरी शॉर्टली We are going to die very shortly. Our life is very short. Within this period, we must settle down our demand. What we want and what you don't want, what you want, what you don't want, there should be one final account of that thing. If you cannot draw the final account of your demand, then ultimately you are going to commit spiritual suicide. You cannot. We must finalize what we want, what we don't want. Srila Saraswati Thakur told, why we are here in this material world, what's the reason behind it? And so long we are here in this material world, what is our final duty, ultimate duty? That thing should be settled down. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navadvip Leela, you can find Mahaprabhu going to East Bengal, now Bangladesh. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Apparently the reason is totally different. He went there to, you know, for giving lesson to different students. But ultimate reason was very secret. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there, Tapan Mishra, one devotee, he was just in confusion about sadhya and sadhana. What bhajan we should do, how to do, ultimately, what I am going to get about these three things, he was in confusion. But night time, in dream, he came to know that Supreme Lord, in the guise of a Sanskrit teacher coming here in your country, you don't know. He is Supreme Lord. You will have to approach Gauranga Mahaprabhu. You will have to go there, Nimai Pandit. Then you can solve all your problems. No problem. You have to go there. Then that Tapan Mishra went there in front of Gauranga Dev, our Gauranga Dev, Nimai Pandit. He was asking all about how to do bhajan, what bhajan we should do. There is different kind of mode of bhajan in different sampradaya. Even different unauthentic sampradaya also there. They are also preaching different way. They are speaking, you should do bhajan this way, that way. But here we see, actually, Nimai Pandit giving complete advice to Tapan Mishra. Is giving complete advice to Tapan Mishra that our bhajan is Krishna bhajan. And not only Krishna bhajan, Nanda Nandan Krishna. And you should know it for sure, Naam Sankirtan is a procedure through which, avidya, through which you can get the ultimate object. The other day I was speaking that Naam Sankirtan is a mode of bhajan to you. For all bonded soul, Naam Sankirtan is a mode of bhajan, sadhan, avidya. But those who are elevated devotee, for them, Naam Sankirtan is itself sadhya. Naam Sankirtan is itself sadhya. Through Naam Sankirtan, what you mean to get? That is a question. So for those elevated devotee, Naam Sankirtan is sadhya. You can get. As for example, I can cite one example from Bhagavatam. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kaviviritam kalmasapaham. You know, those Gopika, they are also listening about Krishna. They are hearing, speaking, with each other, they are talking about Krishna. It seems it is their sadhana. It seems, apparently, it is their sadhana. Not that. In Brahmar Gita also, you can get this kind of advice. Radharani is speaking. Hey, why you are coming to Black Beast? Go! I know you are very clever. Your shrewdness I know. You cannot make fool of me. They are one what Radharani is speaking. Krishna can go away, okay. We cannot see Krishna in front of us, okay. But anyway, we cannot leave his topics. Krishna gone, okay. But we cannot leave the topics of Krishna. Anyway, we are bound to discuss about Krishna all the time. Even if you, Krishna, in front of Krishna, Radharani speaking, if you advise me to forget, I cannot forget. It's not possible. That's why in Kurukshetra, when all Brajavasi, together with Radharani, all Sakhis, they are also going there. When they met Krishna in Kurukshetra, from Vrindavan they are going halfway, from Dwarka they are coming halfway. There, when Radharani speaking in front of Krishna, Krishna came to meet very secretly. That topic is very secret. I can come to this point through Gauranga Leela. My topics is totally different. Actually, that time, Radharani is speaking in front of Krishna in Bengali. Anir Hidayamon, Mor Mon Vrindavan, মনে মনে এক করি মানি। ইউ নো দিস পার্স, ইউ ক্যান রিমেম্বার? নো, ফর আদার কমন পিপল দেয়ার মাইন্ড অ্যান্ড হার্ট টোটালি ডিফারেন্ট, নট প্যারালাল। আনের হৃদয় মন মোর মন বৃন্দাবন, মনে 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 এক করি মানি। ফর কমন পিপল দেয়ার হার্ট ইজ টোটালি ডিফারেন্ট ফ্রম মাইন্ড, আ মাইন্ড ইজ টোটালি ডিফারেন্ট ফ্রম হোয়াট ইজ দেয়ার ইন হার্ট, দেয়ার হার্ট অ্যান্ড মাইন্ড নট প্যারালাল। When your heart and mind parallel, then you are called, you know, actual devotee. Otherwise, some kapat fallacy is there. Mind and heart should be parallel. Jagadananda Pandit, in Jagadananda Prem Vivarta, speaking same thing. In Bengali he is speaking. সরল হইলে গোলার শিক্ষা বুঝিয়া লইবে। ইফ ইউর হার্ট ইজ ভেরি প্লেন হার্টেড, ইফ ইউর মাইন্ড অ্যান্ড হার্ট ইজ ভেরি প্যারালাল, ভেরি শর্টলি আন্ডার দ্য গাইডেন্স অফ এ পিওর ডিভোটি অর গুরু ইউ ক্যান কাম টু নো দ্য অ্যাকচুয়াল টিচিংস অফ চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু। দের ইজ নো অল্টারনেটিভ। ইফ ইউ প্লে ইউর ব্রেন, ইফ ইউ ট্রাই টু ইউজ ইউর এডুকেশন, educational power, money power, man power, together with that all your final effort can go towards this thing, to know that absolute truth. But ultimately you cannot come out successful. Any amount of money power, any amount of manpower, any amount of educational qualification cannot give you success in future. Simply you will have to be parallel from heart, heart and mind. Radharani is speaking, my mind is equal to Vrindavan, not greater than equal to. Those who are doing mathematics, higher mathematics, they know, they use this word, less than equal to, higher than equal to. We cannot use this word, exact equal to. Rather than speaking, my heart is just equal to Vrindavan. If you open your heart, it's Vrindavan. And where I can find you are playing there. So you'll have to go now. Now point is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Gaur Leela, first in Navadvip Leela, you all know, many times I used to speak this thing. In Gaur Leela, Navadvip Leela, you can find, someday Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started the exhibition of Raganuga Bhajan. That was the first exhibition started in Misra's house. Jagannath Misra's house, first exhibition started of Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga. Nobody could realize this point. They thought our Prabhu gone mad, is a brain out of order. Why acting like that, like a madman? After coming back from Gaya to offer funeral cake for father. Now point is that, is it necessary for Supreme Lord to offer funeral cake to Gaya? What do you think? He himself Supreme Lord. Why he going to Gaya to offer funeral cake there? Then all ordinary people, they can think that way. What is the secret reason behind it? What is the secret reason behind it? Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu approaching Gaya? Actually, those ordinary people, they can think, father dying, mother dying, we must go to Gaya to offer this, that. Actually, for common people, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to give lesson to us in such a way, his platform is in such a level, So that common people, those who are having common brain, I mean no spiritual idea, they can accept teaching that way. Like you know in Gita, Krishna Bhagavan speaking different way. Sometime karma yoga, sometime gyan yoga, sometime dhyan yoga, rajguha yoga. Finally bhakti yoga. Arjuna speaking, why? You can speak me the final thing. Why you are speaking now this, after that, this, that? Why you are changing? What is the reason behind it? Because Krishna Bhagavan, knowing that for common people, those who are having different kind of platform, according to their level, they can accept my teaching. So Gita is the most popular book in whole world. Most popular. Translated into different language. How many different languages? Maybe thousands. I cannot speak. And different guru, as their, according to their level, they are explaining different way. But we are not going to accept that thing. Follow me. We are bound to accept the teachings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Baladev Vidyabhushan, because they are in line. Sometimes some confusion can be there inside your heart. Mahajano jeno gato sapanthya. You heard this thing. Mahajano jeno gato sapanthya. 12 Mahajan you know. Prahlad, Bhishma, Narada, so many 12. And finally we get in our line Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada. Now point is there. Whom to follow? Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Pitama Bhishma, Narada. Whom to follow? They are all Dadas Mahajan. They are all practicing Acharya of Bhagavatam. It's okay. But their level is different level. Even Rupa Goswami was speaking, Mahabhagavat, three different kind of Mahabhagavat you can know. First category, second category, third category. Now whom to follow? We are in confusion. That's why in Sara Goswami Stakam we hear this point. Be careful. Nana sasto vichara naiko nipuno saddharma sangsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibubane manyo saranna karo. You know? So what is the final outcome? Under the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sara Goswami, all those Goswami, they are in line. They are giving us final gist. So we need not play our brain over all these things. Our brain is very small. Our capacity is so small, we are in confusion. So we will have to understand what Prabhupada wants to say. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur wants, it is more easy. Day by day, we are getting more easy thing because gist coming to us through Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is the problem. So, Dadas Mahajan there, we also worship during Jagya, Vaishnava Jagya, we always worship Dadas Mahajan, right? But if you like to follow Pitama Bhishma directly, you can be in confusion. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking this way? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking this way? I cannot understand. So why not you follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur? It's more easy. And Prabhupada. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there in Gaya, external reason. final and secret reason was there. He wanted to meet with Ishwar Puripad. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already told Nimai Pandit, that time Gaur. Gauranga Mahaprabhu already told, Gaya Yatta Aaj Mor Hoilo Safal, in Bengali. Today, I come to this pilgrimage, Gaya, the lotus feet of Vishnu, today I am successful, because I meet you. Nathamadaga also speaking this way. Tirtha Yatta, running here and there pilgrimage, Nathamadaga is useless. Tirtha Yatta Parishram, Sakali Moner Bhom, Sarva Siddhi Govinda Charan. Nathamadaga speak. I can prove 100%. 100% I can prove what Narottama Thakur in Kirtan, in all Kirtan, Parthana Prembhuti Yoga there, I can show you 100%. In all Kirtan of Narottama Thakur, I can show you one by one, all the teachings of Goswami there, gist. I can show you 100%. All Rupanika Bhajan, Dara, the procedure, already interpreted. Very clear way, more easy. But you will have to follow under the guidance of a practicing Acharya, pure devotee. You cannot understand. Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj used to keep Parthana Prembhakti Jantika here. Only one book. Parthana Prembhakti Jantika here. No other book. Always doing Harinam, doing pure association, Nitya Siddha Parshad. So this way, especially at present, we are in confusion. Whom to follow, how to follow. Because ultimately, we want to come out successful. But we don't see any hope. Exact procedure we like to know. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there to take Diksha from Ishwar Puripad. That was the final. And after coming back from Gaya, that Nimai Pandit, Gauranga, in Mishra's house, expressing the first exhibition of Rupanuga Bhajan, Raghunath Das Goswami writing Stava Kalpataru. Kadachit Mishra Vase Bhajapati Sutasya Uravirahat Slatatsi Sandhittat Adadad Adhikadarugam Bhujapado. One day, all devotees, they find, what is the condition of our Prabhu? Maybe he has gone mad. Just like madman, rolling down on ground, crying, sometimes shouting. This way, nobody can understand. Now here also one Siddhanta. Sachimata crying, Malinima crying, everybody crying, all devotees crying. Now here also one question coming, why they are crying? They are actually eternal parts of the Prabhu. They should know clearly the reason behind it. Why they cannot understand? Why? They are in Maya? They are in Maya? Maya? Then what? No! They are not in illusion. They are not in Maya. That Mahama, but Mahamaya is not there. Mahamaya means Maya, illusion. There is Jogumaya playing actually. Mahamaya is not there. Ekbar Jogumaya playing. The duty of Jogumaya is to decorate the Leela of Prabhu. Anywhere, be it in Krishna Leela, you can see Putana coming in front of Krishna. We can put, what's that? Putana is Maya? And we heard repeatedly we heard from our Guru Varga, Jaha Krishna Tahanai Maya Radhika. But now how Putana can get entry into Brajadham in front of Krishna even? What is the reason? Vishnu Chakodaya is thinking, no, it's Jogmaya playing this way. Otherwise, it's the duty of Jogmaya to decorate the whole Leela. Sajan Vimohini Maya and Vimukjan Vimohini Maya, two types of Maya there. Those are internal Parshad, for them one kind of Maya, sometime acting like Brahmanda Leela. Yashodama looking inside the face of Krishna, whole Brahmanda, star, moon, even himself, herself. What's that? Some ghost catching my son. Huh? Some ghost, maybe some, yes. So he is acting this, she is acting that way, calling Brahman, and he is doing, oh, Krishna, I am a Vasudeva, I am a Nishinga, I am a... He is using Krishna mantra to rectify Krishna. Because this is my son Krishna, not the Supreme Lord Krishna. This is the idea of Yashodama, you see. This is called sweetness of Leela, pastime, sweetness, this way. Damodar Leela, if you discuss very sweet way, you can understand what is the, you know, sweetness, very sweet way of discuss. So there, Jogmaya is there, Mohamaya is not there. That's why Sachima, Malinima, those who are eternal parcel of Nimai Pandit, I mean Gauranga Mahaprabhu, they cannot understand. They cannot understand. But be sure, that was the first exhibition started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu of Rupanuga Bhajan. And on and on, after that, day by day you can find different kind of, you know, Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, through which we have many things to learn. Each and every action of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, we'll have to follow. Each and every action we'll have to follow, then we can understand the Leela. But Sivas Pandit, Gadadhar, one day Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asking, Gadadhar, Sivas, what you think? Huh? What you see that day? You think I gone mad? You think I gone mad? Sivas, no, I know the reason for why you are coming in this material planet. I know it is your exhibition first started. Now, very shortly we are going to get all different unique treasure. We are going to, very shortly, you are going to express your Leela. So we know. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when giving advice to Tapan Mishra, that Sankirtan is the final, you know, Ovidya Tattva. Through Sankirtan you can get everything. Sambandha means you will have to take shelter of one Sadguru. If you can grow your relationship with Krishna, I mean Supreme Lord, Sambandha Tattva is the vast Tattva. Sambandha Tattva is not a matter of joke. You cannot even start your bhajan if you don't have the knowledge of Sambandha Tattva exactly. You cannot start bhajan even. Popa speaking, until and unless you grow actual relationship with Supreme Lord, Sambandha Tattva is a vast chapter. What is my relation with Gurudev? What is the relation of Gurudev with Krishna? What is the relation of Maya with me? What is the relation of Maya with Krishna? All diversified way of knowing, complete. complete thing. So if you can have this sambandha gyan, then you can start actual bhajan. So Mahaprabhu speaking this way, Mahaprabhu giving advice to Tapan Mishra, you see, all different sat-sastra, authentic sastra, because there is six tamasic puran, six rajasic puran, and six sattvic puran. We have no time. Our time is very limited, life is very short. We have no time to go through all different purans. We have no time. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the final teaching, Srinath Chakravartiya told, Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Pumartha Mahana Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matam Idam Tatradharan Haparaha. Those who are pure Vaishnava, they are less interested about our different kind of scriptures. But be careful. Those who are big, big acharya, those who are big, big acharya, like Param Pujyavad Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Param Pujyavad Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, they are reading Mayavad's Vichar. They are reading. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, Mayavad, don't try to hear anything about Mayavad. Even you have no right to see a Mayavadi. If you by chance come in front of a Mayavadi, instant you will have to take bath with your cloth. What do you mean? Maharaj, you also going to Haridwar to speak Harikatha? Some Mayavad also coming. So you, I never see you are taking bath in Ganga with cloth. You don't see? But really I take bath. Each and every time when I see one Mayavadi, even if this Mayavadi in guise of Vaishnav, maybe in guise of Vaishnav and Mayavadi I can realize by Bhartiya Guru, then instantly I take bath, mental bath. I look Guru Charan, or I look at Surya, sun bath. Different kind of bath is there. So really, believe me, I take bath every time when I meet one Mayavadi. So it's 100% perfect teachings by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But why Keshav Goswami are violating this room? But no, he is not violating. For the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani, he must know this Siddhanta, Mayavad Siddhanta, to break their Siddhanta. Otherwise, he cannot preach Gauranga philosophy in front of Mayavadi. They are very strong. They want to prove that we are above all. We are so strong. Our astuti and pinas are so strong. You cannot compare yourself with us. We are so strong. Really so. Really so. If you go and watch their life, you can see their astuti and pinas is very heavy. Very heavy. But as for Gauranga Mahaprabhu's teaching, we must know this thing. Asasanga tagai Vaishnavachar. Asasanga means Yashisanga tagai Vaishnavachar. I can explain this point someday, tomorrow or today, but time is very limited. As per Gauranga Mahaprabhu's philosophy, we must try to understand this point. Externally, if you look, you can see their astuti and pinas above all, really so. But as per Gauranga philosophy, as per teachings of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, it is useless. Those who are Mayavadi, they are topmost Yashit Sanghi. Those who are Mayavadi, they are topmost Yashit Sanghi. Yashit, I was discussing point, this point, 1 month ago, I think, in Mayapur. Yashit Sangho Tyage Vaishnava Bhajan. Stri Sangho or Krishna Abhakto, Krishna Abhakto, those who are not devotee, their Sangho. In Rasamrita Sindhu also, Rupa Goswami was speaking. If you can put me inside a cage, and if there is fire all around, Rupa Goswami was speaking, if you put me inside a cage, and if there is fire all around, still I can try to live. No reaction in my heart even, and maybe in body. Varam hutavah jala panjarantar vyavasthiti. Same thing, Rupa Goswami is quoting from some place. Better I can say inside a cage and there is fire all around, I can bear that thing. But I cannot bear if I have the chance to see a Mayavadi. They are the topmost Joshi Sanghi. They never talk with any woman. We are talking with Mataji. With a mood that she is my mother or daughter, these two mood. In between there cannot be any mood or any relation. If you can see she is my god sister, today she is your god sister, maybe tomorrow she can become your wife. I cannot believe you. Only there, only these two relations would be there. Either mother, you are my mother, or my, you know, daughter. In between there should not be any relation. But even Mayavadi, they are not talking with any any woman. So they are much more elevated than me. What do you think? Pope are speaking, they are number one Mayavadi. No, they are actually number one Joshi Sanghi. Because Yashit means the mood of enjoyment. I already told. Pratishtha is topmost above all. If I want to enjoy Pratishtha that you are going to give to me, like garbage, whenever you give me any Pratishtha, like garbage, I wash my hand, leg and body instantly. I know this Pratishtha is going to kill me. I like to give all Pratishtha to my Guru Maharaj and Prabhupada. I am less interested about your Pratishtha that you want to confer to me, give to me. Less interested. I have no interest at all. But that Mayavadi, they are exhibiting astuti and finances. Through that, they want to prove that we are topmost. So they are Yashit mean, Kamini Yashit, woman is also one kind of, if you have mood. If those Matajis, they have the mood to enjoy a man, this is also Joshit Sanghi. So this way, Joshit Sangho, different kind. One is, you know, Pratishtha Yashit, Kamini Yashit, and conscious opulences, money, and if you want to gather billions of dollars, Prabhupada speaking, you need not deposit billions of dollars. Prabhupada speaking, you must follow Upadeshamrita by Prabhupada. Upadeshamrita by Rupa Goswami Pad, but one Upadeshamrita is there by Prabhupada. There you can find different kind of advice by Prabhupada in his whole life. Same thing you can find in whole life, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving advice, that is called Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav. You must go through. Nobody can protect you. If you cannot take shelter of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, repeatedly I am speaking. There is no compromise in my heart. I cannot speak different way, like Sahajiya. You will have to follow Manoshikha with all interpretation, explanation by our Guru Bhargava, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, Chaitanya Shiksha Amrita, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Shiksha, Manoshikha by Raghunath Das Goswami, Upadesha Amrita, Shiksha Stock, and Upadesha Amrita by Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhu. And by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can. It was compiled after Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone in the year of 1914. In the year of 1914, in the year of 1914, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur disappeared from this material world, after that, in the year of maybe 1916 or 1918, I forget the year. First, it was published Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav, you can remember. First published then. After that, maybe 80 years or 100 years after, by the mercy of Gurudev and Prabhupada, I published this in Bengali, not in English. It's Bengali now. Someday, by the mercy of Prabhupada, can be translated into English. I don't know when. But I know Param Pujabhat Naran Maharaj, Naran Goswami Maharaj published some in magazine. Very small amount. Not all. Previously. In all from Mathura it was published. But very small amount, not all. The book is very fat. You can get total advice. You need not fight with anybody. You can open and get all the, you know, advised by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. You need not fight with anybody. You can get everything. Now you see, in Gaur Lila we find first exhibition started. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very shortly took sannyas, coming here in Nalachal. We are very lucky. We have this place by Srila Bhakti Vaibhava Parigoshi Maharaj. We have the chance to discuss this kind of Gauranga philosophy, we have the chance to do Sankirtan. We are very grateful to him. In this Nilachal Dham, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, manifesting all secret Leela. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are Gauriya devotees, for them, this Nilachal Khetra is the topmost place. Those who are Gauriya devotee, for them, this Nilachal Khetra is the topmost place where you can get the taste of Vipralambha. Maybe you can fight with me, you can say Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way. Why? We know Vrindavan is the topmost place. Vrindavan topmost place. Really so? Vrindavan is topmost place. Vrindavan is topmost place. But when Mahaprabhu exhibiting the Baba of Radharani, that is more excellent. More excellent. First 6 years Mahaprabhu going to South India, here and there, different place. And after that, Mahaprabhu sitting in Gambhira and doing this Leela, I mean, very exclusive Leela. Very exclusive Leela. Very secret Leela. Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. When Rupa Goswami Pad came, when you know Rupa Goswami Pad, his life and teaching is the final outcome by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Rupa Goswami Pad later came, don't eternal parshad. But Rupanuga Bhajan, we have no chance to speak now. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking that way, but when we find प्रिय स्वरूपे दैत्य स्वरूपे प्रेम स्वरूपे सहजावि रूपे ततानुरूपे सबिलास देन वी कैन कम टू नो वेल चैतन्य महापुरुष हार्ट इज जस्ट इक्वल टू रूप गोस्वामी पाद एग्जैक्टली इक्वल द हार्ट ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु इज इक्वल द हार्ट ऑफ रूप गोस्वामी. हाउ यू नो, हाउ यू नो, during Ratha Yatra you can remember when Mahaprabhu is with ecstatic feeling dancing and crying in front of Jagannath, then Rupa Goswami Pad, that year Rupa Goswami Pad was there and following Prabhu, his mood. I told you, for Rupanuga Bhajan, those who are really interested for Raganuga Bhajan, they must follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in toto. In toto, if you can understand at all, if you cannot understand, then you are misled. Then you can get whole Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a total explanation of Raganuga Bhajan. There Rupa Goswami watching, by the mercy of Prabhu, he could realize what is the mood of Prabhu. Then after coming back to Haridas Thakur Bhajan Kutir, because Rupa Sanatan, they are so humble attitude. Today night I think they are going to discuss this Trinada Viswanishi Sroga, I think so. So I have the chance to hear this exact explanation of what do you mean by Trinadavi. Maharaj Dandavat, he is not Trinadavi. I can, if I have the chance to discuss this point, I can speak in front of you. Maybe 10 minutes or 20 minutes, I don't know. Time is very limited. Still I can try, by the mercy of Prabhupada. There you know, actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing, speaking some sloka. Huh? But Rupa Goswami Pad going back to, after Ratha Yatra, my time, going back to Bhajan Kutir, immediately write one sloka, very nice sloka, I can discuss after. Then, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu next morning came here, after taking bath in Ganga, Mahaprabhu came here, and Haridas Thakur was there, Swarup Damodar, Rai Ramananda and Mahaprabhu came. Haridas Thakur, where is Rup? Rup gone, just is coming. After that, Mahaprabhu find one, you know, leaf writing there. In Rup. After that, Mahaprabhu, what is this? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, knowing everything, Supreme Lord, watching, oh my God, so nice look. Who write? Rup. Huh? Rup write? Then Mahaprabhu asking to Swarup Gosai, how Rupa Naya exactly knowing my heart? How is that possible that Rup, you know, knowing everything, what is there inside my heart? Swarup Gosai is thinking, that's why we know that he is enjoying full kripa. He is enjoying your full kripa. That's why he can translate your heart. He is enjoying your full kripa. That's why he can translate your heart. What is there inside your heart is automatically expressed in the heart of Rupa. Same thing about Sadguru and Satsisha. Sadguru, Satsisha, same thing. If you are staying thousands of miles away from Gurudev, Sadguru, if you are enjoying full kripa of Gurudev, you can understand the heart of Gurudev, what Gurudev want to do right now. What Gurudev want to give advice to me, you can realize from distant place. So duty of all our Guru Varga, what is the duty of all our Guru Varga? Sri Chaitanya Manovhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale. Jena means it is third case of Karak, case division. as per Sanskrit grammar, is the third caste division. Keno, teno, si chaitanya manabhishtam sthapitam jena bhutale. So duty of all our Guru Varga, those who are actual Guru Varga, Sadguru, the duty of all our Guru Varga is to establish and implement the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Chaitanya Manavishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale. So we can follow our Goswami, those who are Sara Goswamis, and after that those Goswami, Jiva Goswami, other all Goswamis coming, Samananda Srinivasa Jade is coming, Narottama Thakur, we must follow them. Then we can get the exact teachings by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Otherwise we cannot understand properly. So now you see, last 12 years Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing nice leela. Total 24 years, 24 vasa se se jai maga mas, tar punnimata kori purina pabhu korila sanyas, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita written. That 24 years Prabhu expressing Leela there, Navadip Leela there. After that, 24, doing this Leela after 21st year. For total 48 years. 6 years going here and there, another 6 years going here and 12 years gone. And next 12 years in castle, in Gufa, Gambhira. What is the meaning of Gambhira? If you want to know the exact meaning of Gambhira, expert Sanskrit version, you must know it for sure. Gambhira means very secret thing, very, very heavy. Secret thing is there inside Gambhira, which cannot be exposed in front of all common people, which cannot be exposed. Why? Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami many times speaking, jar lagi bolite bhoy se jodi na jane. For those demonic character, those people, for them, I don't like to speak those secret things. Well, if I can express this mood this way, if they cannot understand by the blessing of Mayadevi, I am saved. Those who are devotees, they can understand my mood. They can understand the secret thing. I don't like to express this thing in front of all demonic character, those who are demonic people. Krishnadas Goswami speaking this way. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, those who are Brajavasis, I mean Navadvipvasi, they are also Brajavasi. Those who are Navadvipvasi, they are also Brajavasi. Those Brajavasi, they are going to die without Gaurhari. Without Mahaprabhu, they are going to die. They cannot live. Murari Gupta Karsha and other things you can find so secret, explanation there about those Brajavasis. What is the condition of those Brajavasis there, those who are staying in Navadvip? What is their condition? Same condition what these Brajavasis they used to feel that time. Same. They are also going to die without Gauranga. They cannot live. But actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here expressing this Leela, Sannyas Leela, here doing that time, those Brajavasis, they are coming every year. during Rathayatra time. During the period of Rathayatra, it was the usual rule that all those Vrajavasis get together, and it was the duty of Sivananda Sen to guide them all the way up to Neelachal Dham, you know. Now I want to explain you this point. What is their heart? They cannot leave. They are coming long way from different way, Navadvip, Shantipur, different place. They get together in one place, then all they are coming, old ladies, all Matajis, Pitajis, everybody, old man, all devotees, they are coming. We are in enthusiastic mood, with Sankirtan mood. They are coming. Almost 700 kilometers from Navadvip to, you know, if you calculate, almost 700. So average, if you walk 15 kilometers, 20 kilometers, then you calculate how much time it takes. Now you calculate. Two months, you can calculate how much months it takes, how much time. Then they are going there. They are staying with Mahaprabhu for 4 months, Chaturmasa. They are staying there, doing Sankirtan, Leela, everything they are doing, 4 months. 2 months here, 4 months, six, another 2 months you calculate coming. 8 months gone. And 4 months, they are not crying, where is gold, where is gold? Follow. This is the condition. If you can understand their mood, if you can understand their heart, then you can enjoy your bhajan. You can if you can understand, you can jump, dance. First of all, you will have to follow Gaurlila. Even if you want to enter into Krishna Lila, this is a rule set by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Rupanuga, Biswanath Chakravarti Pad, even Biswanath Chakravarti Pad giving a skeleton discussion about Raganuga Bhajan. There you can find same advice. You can follow Gaurlila in toto. In toto you will have to follow Gaurlila. Through Gaurlila you can understand Krishna Lila. Through Gaurlila. If you can understand Gaurlila, then you can understand Krishna Lila. I mean, you can get entry into Krishna Lila, otherwise not. That's why Prabhupadananda Saraswati Pad speaking this way. Prabhupadananda Saraswati Pad, topmost Rupanuga, Raganuga Bhajan, is doing in Kammaban. Gurudev of Gopal Bhatta Goswami is the Gurudev of Gopal Bhatta Goswami, from originally from South India. He is writing so many things. We have no time to go through those teachings. Very nice. There you can find Prabhupadananda Saraswati Pad writing Yatha Yatha Gaura Padar Binde Binde Tavaktim Kitapunna Rasi Tatha Tatha Utsarpati Hidi Akasmat Radha Padam Mujo Sudhambu Rasi. यथा यथा गौर पदार बिंदे बिंदे तो भक्तिम कितपुन्न राशि तथा तथा उत्सर्पति हिदि अकस्मात राधा पदाम मुझे सुभान सुधाम्बु राशि. यू सी अकॉर्डिंग टू डिग्री ऑफ योर इंक्लिनेशन सबमिशन unto lotus feet of Nityananda, Gauranga, Athu Gurudev, of course. The more you grow your submission unto the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, the more you can understand the glories of Radharani. Directly there is no chance. You cannot jump. Guru Varga never allow you to jump like monkey. Never. Like monkey. Never approve. You will have to become slow and steady. Then you can come out successful. So you can find there yatha yatha gaura padara vinde vinde to bhaktim kitopunna rasi tatha tatha usarpati idi akasmat radha padamujo sudhambu rasi. Biswanath Chakravarti Pad giving nice explanation for those Ashtakalin Leela. Ashtakalin Leela, Biswanath Chakravarti giving advice that this way, side by side, what is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu during Sankirtan? What is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu in morning time, 4 o'clock? What is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 7 o'clock? What is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 10:30, 10 o'clock? What is the mood of Radharani, 2 o'clock? This way, you see, he can get clear conception. The mood of Radharani is there inside the mood of Gauranga. Gauranga Mahaprabhu enjoying this Leela. Then he is expressing some sort of mood. We Gauriya, we must follow Gauranga Leela. After Sankirtan, whole night in Siva Sangam, Prabhu crying, taking rest for some time, a while. But that time Mahaprabhu crying, following different kind of mood. What is the mood of Radharani? In morning time. Just morning time. There. Dekhiya urono doy, bindadevi byasto hoy, kunje nana rabo korailo. Sukosari paddo suni, uthe Radha Nilamoni. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Bhajan Rahasya. We have the chance to follow Bhajan Rahasya, Chaitanya Sikhamito, side by side you can understand. But if you go through the preface of Bhajan Rahasya, you can find what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Preface. In preface writing of Bhajan Rahasya, what Keshav Goswami Maharaj writing, you can see. Then you can understand why they are so strict. I can discuss this point tomorrow. I can discuss this point also tomorrow, I think. Why Guru Varga so strict? Why Keshav Goswami Maharaj so strict? Parampuja, Keshav Goswami Maharaj don't allow you to do Jam Kirtan right now. Parampuja, Keshav Goswami Maharaj not allowing you to follow Jaiva Dharma Rasa Tattva. Why? Even Keshav Goswami Maharaj when publishing Jaiva Dharma first, I can show you the volume. Rasatattva he cut away, separate. Totally separate. Totally separate. Why? What's the reason behind it? As some of our Guru Bhargava, they are also speaking, well, we must, under the guidance of pure devotees, those who are actually following Guru Bhargava in toto, they can somehow discuss Bhajan Rahasya. They can go through Jama Kirtan. There is a different kind of opinion. Parampuja Madhav Goswami Maharaj doing Jama Kirtan. Keshav Goswami Maharaj allowing, not allowing. No, not now. Why? Keshav Goswami Maharaj want to speak. If you can grow your bhakti day by day, your serving mood, If your serving mood is very perfect, if your serving mood is 100% perfect, if there is no serving mood, then you cannot get this thing. There is no serving mood. Atah Krishna Namadi na bhavet grajyam indriyoi. One by one I am giving you document, example. Atah Krishna Namadi na bhavet grajyam indriyoi. Sevan mukhehi jivaya madau swayameva spurtya adah. Is written in Rasamrita Sindhu also, you can find this thing, same thing. Atah Krishna Namadi na bhavet grajyam indriyoi. Sevan mukhehi jivaya madau swayameva spurtya adah. All your sense organ, if now totally engaged in seva, totally, all of your sense organ now totally engaged in seva, then and only then this kind of naam can appear into your tongue. Pure name, Harinam. And that pure Harinam ultimately can exhibit, unveil all the mystery there in Harinam. Everything is there in Harinam, inside Harinam. All Leela, all pastime, everything you can find inside Harinam in total. This Harinam is so important thing. Rupa Goswami Pada expressing this mood by Radharani. I can discuss this point tomorrow, not today. You can find how Radharani crying. Through Krishnam, all the sense organ of Radharani transcended now, but still, Radharani speaking, I am now mad. I like to see the you know, so nice beauty of Krishna, Rasamrita Sindhu. Krishna is Rasamrita, ocean of beauty. I mean, ocean of rasa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Rupa Goswami Pad in Allahabad. Hey Rup, I am unable to give you the total taste of that Rasamrita Sindhu. But anyway, you can, somehow we can get the taste of that Rasamrita Sindhu, one drop. It is my effort to give you one drop. I like to give you in your tongue, so that you can get the taste of that Rasamrita Sindhu. Big thing, you see. We cannot play with this mood. We cannot play with this mood. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressing this mood. So Vishwanath Chakravarti was giving advice, Ashtakalin Leela, Gaur Leela, you follow, side by side you can get the mood of Radharani and you can get everything, finally. In Gambira Leela also, I can try to explain tomorrow also, big discussion tomorrow, very important. Inside Gambira Leela, inside Gambira Mandir, the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very important. Very important. There you can find that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enjoying the full, I mean the this separation, I mean mood, totally there inside Gambira Mandir. Sometimes crying, sometimes shouting like mad. This way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing Leela. Anudghatta Dharatrayam Bhittitrayam Uru, Raghunath Das Goswami writing. anudghatta dara trayam bhittityam uru. There is a big fencing wall all around Gambhira. Big wall. But still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, three gates. First gate, second gate, third gate, all close. Although sevak, they don't allow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go outside. Because many times it happens so, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu vanished from Gambhira. Where is Prabhu? Three doors, close, lock and key. There is big, you know, wall. Still, Prabhu, where gone? Our Prabhu. Raghunath Das Goswami writing in Stavakalpatru. Anudghatta dara trayam, bhitti trayam uru, bilanga uchai kalengik surabhi madhya patita. Raghunath Das Goswami writing. Big wall is there, three gate close. But still Mahaprabhu gone. Whole night Sarup Gosai, Raya Ramananda, full troops. They are searching, where is our Prabhu? Maybe Prabhu disappear from this material world? Then we can die instant. With kerosene light. They are searching all around, you know, Nilachal Dham, here and there, sometime in sea. Sometimes they find Chaitanya Mahaprabhu falling in sea. Some fisherman, he's running. Sarup Gosai going, hey, why you are flying? Oh, there is ghost. Don't go there. Ghost? Where is ghost? There. I was busy catching fish, but in net, some ghost is there. Ghost? Long ghost. Ghost? I know mantra. To drive away ghost, come to me, come to me. Then Sarup Gosai giving in his head, ha! Ghost gone, now show me where is that goat. Now show me where is that ghost. There, there, you go. I cannot go, I am so afraid. Let me see where is goat. There, in my net. They find, oh my God, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there, big hand and leg. All joints, you see, unlock. Land. Even in the Leela of Radharani, some extra. Our Guru was speaking, when Radharani manifesting Leela, that time, that kind of dangerous in it, is a speciality there. Very special. Though same thing, but still some speciality there. Now Sarup Gosai find, is it our Prabhu? Our Prabhu there in net. Then they arrange, Prabhu come out, then Prabhu take out from net. Then they are doing Sankirtan, full mood. Sankirtan, Sankirtan, Sankirtan. Then Prabhu, consciousness coming. Who is there? Where I am? Prabhu, whole night we are searching you. Somehow we find you here, in sea beach. Well, how I come here? We don't know. Oh, Swarup, why you bring me here? I was very nice there. I was enjoying the water game of Krishna and Radharani there, all gopis. You take me here? You disturb me? That time. Another day, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Jagannath temple outside, where the Orissa cows, small, small cows, they are licking the body of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, just like tortoise. Tortoise, you know? Very small. Hand or legs and hand are gone inside, like Kurmakriti. So different kind of Leela Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting. Very nice. Whole night they are searching. Ultimately, they find Mahaprabhu lying outside Jagannath Mandir. Those who are Orisha cows, they are licking the body of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They are going and crying, doing Sankirtan, after their hands and legs coming out of body. Then they are doing Sankirtan, they bring their Prabhu. the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if you can understand, everything you can know. Nobody can stop you to enter into Brajalila. But be careful. You will have to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing this secret Leela inside Gambhira? Why not outside? Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing Sankirtan with all devotees while he is enjoying this rasa inside Gambhira? It is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bohiranga Laiya Kare Naam Sankirtan, Antaranga Laiya Kare Rasa Sadan. Those who are internal, they are enjoying actually. And with all devotees, those who are coming from Navadvip here, there, is doing Sankirtan. But through Sankirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu getting the darshan of Krishna. Though see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. Radha and Krishna, both. But still, when Sankirtan going on, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, I can speak some Leela of Gambhira. Then you can understand. I can explain some Leela from Gambhira Leela. Sometime, night 12 over, 12:31 over, Govinda servant, I mean Sevak, became very angry. Oh Raimahasaya, oh Sarva Dhammadhar Prabhu, what you are speaking in front of my Prabhu so that Prabhu always crying? You cannot speak nice things so that my Prabhu can dance and laugh? What do you speak so that Prabhu always cry? You cannot speak nice thing? Then they are laughing. So plain hearted, Govinda is so plain. So his heart is like child. Second Sachi Mata. Govinda is less interested about this, what is going there inside Gambhira. He is interested about, I like to do seva. Now it is the time of Prabhu to take prasadam. But you are speaking, what you are speaking, Prabhu crying, no sense, nothing. Prabhu cannot take prasadam, I cannot do seva. Then Sarup Gosai Raya Ramananda is saying, Govinda today very angry with us. Prabhu, today we are going, huh? You take rest now. We are going. Tomorrow we can again come. Today we are going, tomorrow we can come again. Then you take rest today. Mahaprabhu speaking, what about your rest? What do you mean by rest? When you are doing Sankirtan, when you are doing Kirtan, when you are speaking Harikatha in front of me, that is my actual rest. That time I am totally taking rest. But when you go away, you cannot understand the mood, my mood. I cannot stay inside room. My craziness going up and up. You go away, stop speaking Harikatha, stop your Kirtan, you can see the condition, my condition. I cannot stay inside room. I'm feeling sometime Krishna calling me, come. I like to go outside. But there's lock and key. I bounce with wall and there's blood coming out. Oh Prabhu, what you do? All blood coming out from you. What you doing? I don't know. I'm just mad. I like to go outside. Nobody allow me to go outside. So this is the condition, you see. If you want to go away from this material condition, if you want to uplift yourself, there should not be any material feeling inside your heart. There should not be any feeling, material, but it's a must. When you are coming here in this material world, there is automatically one disease catching us. That is called material disease. Baba Rog. It's called Baba Rog. Material disease. If you want to cure this disease, day and night you will have to do Sankirtan. And Gauranga Leela you will have to hear fast. No other medicine I can prescribe. Same thing I started, the sloka I started with. What sloka? I started with one sloka nicer.
Sansar sindu uttarani hidayam yadi sad sankirtanamrita rase ramate manoshed premam budhau viharane yadi chitta biti chaitanna chanda charane kuruta anuragam chaitanna chanda charane kuruta anuragam.
Who writing? Popadananda Saraswati Bhakti. Sansar sindu uttarane yadi hidayam yadi sad. At all, if you want to go out of this material world, out of the influence of these three modes of nature,
sansar sindu uttarane hidayam yadi sad sankirtanamrita rase ramate manoshet.
And by chance, if you are lucky that you are getting full enjoyment through sankirtan, this condition. Chet, chet means Sanskrit word. Chet. Sankirtanamrita rase ramate manoschet. If your mind is totally getting enjoyment, if your heart and mind dancing fully through Sankirtan, then you are lucky. Then now it is the time you are going to go out of this material bondage. Then you can do Harinam Sankirtan nice. Then, so Prabhupada Saraswati writing, Sankirtanamrita rase ramate manaschet premam budhau viharane yadi chitta vitti. If you want to swim in the ocean of prema, if you want to swim in the ocean of prema, you like? Then you will have to
sansar sindu uttarani hidayam yadi sa sankirtanamrita rase ramate manoschet premam budhau viharane yadi chitta viti chaitanna chanda charane kuruta anuragam chaitanna chanda charane kuruta anuragam
vancha kalpadurvasike pasind bevacha patitanam pavana bhavishna bhyo namon. If you have any question, no, I give answer to all question that is supposed to come.